right? Because you most of you work with the Apple computer. The CleanCheck web is nice to see when you are in an airport, your CleanChecks. But to work is not a tool to work. Okay? If you want to work with Invisalign, you have to work with the CleanCheck Pro. Okay? Because now it's like, of course we can have now instead of an iPhone X, we can have an you know the Nokia that we were using a few years ago, that they were nice, but the thing that we can achieve now with this tool is amazing. So why we are going to not use the powerful tool that we have? The CleanCheck Pro will allow you to communicate better with the technician of Invisalign, also to be more accurate with the final position that you want to do, but it doesn't save you to tell the technicians about the sequence of movement, okay? So with the CleanCheck Pro, you can design the final position, but you have to write then the way you want to achieve that result, okay? So, everybody have the CleanCheck in the computer? So, the first thing that I want you to customize the CleanCheck to your own preference. So let's open the case number one. Case number one, that is midline shift and IPR crowding. Okay, everybody have it?
Yes.
Okay. What we are going to learn in this case is how to modify the attachments in shape and size. We are going to learn how to eliminate the power reach, how to modify the torques, how to add IPR and change the amount of IPR, how to perform rotations, how to do mass intrusion, so intrude more than one teeth at the same time. Okay? Look at the model that you have in the CleanCheck Pro, and we are going to work with that to get, and we're going to do an exercise. We're going to do this final picture of the CleanCheck, okay? Where we're going to add a different attachments, we're going to change the torques, we're going to give more intrusion, okay? So, first of all, open the CleanCheck, and first, let's go to modify and to adapt the CleanCheck to your own preference. So, go here, upper left, to the here where it says CleanCheck Pro. Everybody here?
Yeah.
Upper left, push, and go to settings. Okay. Everybody follow me? Upper left, CleanCheck Pro. And settings. Here we can adapt the CleanCheck to our own preference with colors of the background of the color of the teeth. You can see here the font size. We can see a small, default, or large. As you can see here, you can see how the text on the right changes. Small, default, and large. Okay, I have selected the option large. Okay, because I prefer to read in a comfortable way. Okay, so it reduces a little bit the screen where you see the model of the clean check, but it's better for you to review the instructions. Okay, so in the font size, I select large. Okay, in colors, you can change the color of the background to, okay, background, you can do it white, you can do it black, any color that you want, okay? Normally, I work with the black one, and when I have to prepare for presentations, I put the white one, okay? But the black one is easier to work, because when we put, for example, the occlusal view, okay, and we work with the superimposition, okay, give me, okay, it's easy to see the change, okay, but whatever, it's your own preference. I prefer to work with the white or with the black. Okay, you can show or not the patient information. Okay, you select show patient information, you will see here what says case one, midline shift and IPR crowding, when says here. You use, you put the show patient information, you will see here the name of the patient. Okay, the rotation, you can select free form, simple or precise. Okay, we prefer a rotation really precise. This is the one that is selected by default. Okay, and the default zoom, okay, is the zoom that you get when you open the ClinCheck. Depends on the size of your screen. Okay, by default is the medium. You have a big screen like the one I have, like 15 inch screen, you select the XL, still is adapted to the screen. Okay, so depends on the size of your screen. The default is the medium, and then in the, you can see 3D modification preference. You can allow non-recommended IPR values. If you select this option, you can do more than 0.5 millimeters of IPR. If you don't have this option selected, you only can do 0.5 millimeters of IPR in each contact point. Okay? So if you have that selected, you will do more than 0.5. Unless, okay, if you don't select, less than 0.5. And here, will tell you if you want to measure the change, including the byte correction or not. Okay, normally what I have selected is allow non-recommended IPR values, because sometimes I do more than 0.5 millimeters of IPR. Okay, and I include also the measurements, including the byte correction. Okay, so I want you, everybody, I want to put the white background, everybody please, white background. In tooth, let's put the medium, no, let's put the dark. By default is the medium, let's put the dark color. The color of the attachment, we're going to use the green. In the upper right corner, the second green. Okay, everybody see here? Let's see the second green. The tooth number, let's change to the red. Okay? And the occlusion, let's put the alternative. and then go to okay. Okay, background white, tooth dark, attachment the second green, okay, tooth number red, and occlusion alternative, and then go to okay. Everybody have it? Now let's go to the part we say the tools close to the text. You can see here. Look at the screen. Here in tools, we are going to find all the things and all the options that we can find with the ClinCheck Pro in tools. Okay? So we go inside the tools. And the option that we have is the superimposition, where we can see the before and after superimposition. The grid is the tool that we use to measure many things. So if you want to rotate, okay, if you open the and you put the grid, you rotate the model over the grid. Okay, but if you want to move the model, you have to go here down. Look at the screen, please. Here down and select so you can move instead of rotate. Everybody follow me? So if you want to measure the amount of expansion, what you can do is some zoom. You can put, for example, the midline in the middle of one line, okay, and with the grid you can measure the amount of movement. Okay, so you put, for example, you take this line for reference, okay, and with the grid you can, I use many times the grid to measure the amount of proclination, the amount of expansion, also to compare one side to the other one. Also, for example, you can see, I want to see if the contact points between second premolar and first molar are symmetric. I move, for example, the first and second, the first molar and second to this point, I follow the line and I can see that the contact point of the 26 is like 2 millimeters mesialized compared with the 16. Can you see? We want to see if this contact point is symmetric with this one. We push the vertical view, so the occlusal view, okay? Go to the occlusal view. Okay, go here, push the occlusal view, now it's selected, go to the grid. And then put the contact point exactly here. And then follow the line. Then you can see that this molar is 2 millimeters initial to this one. Okay? It can give you information about the amount of distalization you want to do or whatever. More options that we have. The attachment. Okay? You can show the attachments or hide the attachments. Okay? Attachments, you can show them or hide them. At the beginning, when I work, well, I like to see the attachments at the beginning, but when I'm working with the sequence of movement, normally I disconnect the attachments. Okay, just to see more clear how the teeth moves. Also, you can see the occlusal contact points, where you can see the interference. Okay? You can see the blue points are interference of occlusion. Okay? Well, let's make it easier. Let's go again to here, to the ClinCheck Pro. Let's go again here, settings, and the occlusion, go to default. It will be easier for you, because you see the red and green, that is easier, okay? So, ClinCheck Pro again, settings, and in colors of occlusion, select default, and go to okay. Okay, you will see the green and red. So, you can hide the occlusal contact points or show the occlusal contact points. Also, you can see the IPR, or you can hide the IPR, the tooth movement assessment, where it will tell you, okay, the difficulty of the movement that they are doing, the view, you have different views, single, where you want to see the occlusal views together, okay, this, the view, the tooth movement assessment is what is telling you, okay, the difficulty of the movement. Normally, I have this disconnected because I don't care about what they tell me about if it's difficult or not. Because what is difficult for them, for me is not. Okay? So I prefer not, nobody con giving me, you know, conditions. Okay? In the view, the single is by default. Double occlusal. Side by side, you can see a composite of different of the five. Okay, let's go again to the view, to single view, the tooth movement table. You can see here what are the, in the final stage, okay, what are the position of the, of InVisalign has done for you, okay. Also, if you have modified with the ClinCheck Pro and you select doctor, they will tell you the movement you have done, and you can see here the difference between what they did and you have done, okay. So once again, you go to the tooth movement table to see the amount of movement that they have done in upper teeth. Here, look at here. You can see the upper and lower. Okay? And also, you can select here the amount of movement on crown and root. If you select the align, you will see the values of the movement that align have done. If you go to doctor, you will see your movements. And here in different, you will see the difference between the, what they did and you have done. For example, maybe they have done 10 degrees of root torque and you modify to 15. And you will see the difference. It's just for information for you. Okay, just giving you information about what you are doing. Because it's something that we don't use many times, you don't have to put that here in the toolbar. Okay, you can see also the Bolton analysis, where they will tell you exactly what is the size of each six tooth in the upper and the lower arch. So doing that, you can see the size of your teeth prior the IPR. Okay, so you will see here if you have Bolton discrepancy, And also you can check, for example, we can see here that the upper right, central, and upper left, the upper left is a little smaller than the upper right. The lateral is more or less the same. You know, we have like a small difference in the size of the tooth, not a really big, but you can see that and you can check in the moment you want to plan your IPR. Okay? So analyzing these numbers, you can be really precise about the amount of IPR that you can do. Okay? I think it's amazing. Because now you have calculated by the scan the size of the tooth. You don't have to measure with the, you know, with your tool in your clinic. Now the only thing that you have to do is to take a good scan or a good impression and then go to the tool of Bolton and they will give you all this information. And when you have the information, you have the power. Because now you know where and how to do the IPR. You can also, in the case you have by correction, over correction, you can select all these things. The tooth number of the teeth, if you want to use them to communicate with the technicians. And another tool is the export. You can convert your ClinCheck to a video. You can make a screenshot, okay, of the view that you have. For example, imagine that we have a Mac computer. You know that with the Mac computer we can do with command, we can do like this to take a control screen of the part that you want, or you can go to export movie. If you go to movie, then you can decide what is the perspective that you want to convert to a movie. I recommend you not to give that to the patient, okay? Because they don't know if you have done a ClinCheck with an overcorrection, okay? They don't know if you have done the ClinCheck with overjet because you need the overjet. So it's better not to give that to the patient. You did for your presentation, but don't give that to the patient, okay? And here you can select sport movie. The current is the view that you have, okay? And different perspective, side by side, the three together, occlusal. For example, imagine that we want to do a video of the occlusal view. We select the occlusal, the speed normal, and the quality depends, but I prefer to convert a high quality. If you are going to use it for marketing reason, select the show doctor information, and then right here, for example, and also you can right here the website you have of your clinic. Okay? So if we convert that, then we are going to save in the desktop sample one, and we share. We are exporting the video. And what is it? And here, if we open, look here in the upper left, you can see here in the upper left the information, my information, and the information of my clinic. Okay? You can do it, or you prefer not to put the information, you can remove it. Okay? And with that, you can use different views. So we can customize the toolbar that we have here. Okay, so go in tools, go here to customize toolbar. So you can put in the toolbar the thing that you want. For example, for me, the superimposition are important because I use it always. The width are important, the attachments are important, the occlusal are important, the IPR, the tool movement assessment, no, that's why I have it disconnected. The view, I don't have, I disconnect the view. The tool movement table, I disconnect it. The bolt-on, I leave it. The bike correction, I leave it. In the case I'm going to use Pontix, I leave it. I disconnect the occlusal plane because it's something that I don't change. You know, I leave in the toolbar the things that I use normally in all the clean checks. Okay? But if I want to use the other things, I just have to go to the tool. Okay, so go to the customize toolbar. And these are the things that I have put in my cases. Okay, so take a couple minutes to customize your own toolbar. And we can, okay. The idea is to put in the toolbar the things that you are going to use in all your patients. Okay, because the rest of the things are really easy to find it. Just go to the tools and you can find the rest. Everybody follow me?
Yes.
Yes? So please take a couple of minutes to customize your toolbar. If you need some help, please raise your hand. Everybody have it? Yes? We can continue? Okay, now our clean check and our toolbar is customized. And then we are going to see that we receive the clean check. Okay, this is the clean check that the InVisalign gives us. And we are going to review before going to create modification. We have to see what they are doing. Okay? What they are doing. As you can see, they are just moving from 3 to 3. Okay? They are maintaining the triangular shape of the arch and only moving from 3 to 3. Also, I check the clean check and you can see how. Everybody know how to modify that, okay? Here you have the zoom and here, okay? In the lower part right, you can modify. You want to see rotation or you want to move, okay? So you can change to rotate the model or to move bodily, okay? So we check the clean check, and what can you see here is that we don't have any over yet. We have some over yet, but with a lot of contact with the lower incisors. We have some proclination of upper and lower incisors. We have class 2 here, okay? Because just Invisalign Light ClinCheck, they will not allow you to modify the occlusion to a class 1, but we can do it, okay? In a different way, but you can do it, okay? If we see here that we need to solve the class 2, what do you need to create? You need to create overjet, okay? If we are going to use class 2 elastics, we need to expand the upper arch more. We need to derotate the molars, okay? We need to give some expansion, and we need to create some overjet for the class 2 elastics, okay? So, okay, we have seen all the things that we want to modify. Now, go here to create modification. And when we create the modification, we see all the things that they have put for us. They have done some IPR with no sense. Okay, asymmetric in different contact points, I don't know why. They haven't expanded the arches, and you can see that the speed curve in the lower arch, we can reduce a little bit the lower speed curve, and also we can reduce the lower incisors proinclination, because we need to reduce a little bit also the upper incisor proclination. Okay? So, what is the final picture that I want to see you here? We are going to change from what you have in your screen to this situation. Okay? We are going to put horizontal gingival bevel attachment 5 millimeters. Horizontal gingival bevel attachment 5 millimeters in the first molar. Also, you can, here's the 3, but we can 3 or 5 millimeters, okay? Horizontal gingival bevel attachment in this premolar and in this premolar. Vertical attachment in this one. We are going to intrude the upper incisors. We are going to intrude the lower incisors in order to create also, we are going to reduce the torque of the lower to create overjet. The Invisalign Light option doesn't allow you to put precision cuts, but you can cut by yourself the aligners in the office. So imagine that you make a mistake, and at the end you ask for a light, and at the end you need to solve a class 2. What you have to do is to prepare the case, to create the overjet, and then by yourself cut here, bond the button here, cut here, bond the button here, and you can use the class 2 elastics. Okay? So, the first thing, let's remove the IPR. Go to the here. You can, if you go to IPR, you can select hide the IPR or show the contours of IPR. Okay? Always select show the contours of IPR when you want to modify that. Okay, we go to IPR, so put and remove contours of IPR. And now, let's go to the red point and remove all the IPR. Okay? If you make a mistake, you can go here to undo, and they will reverse the last movement that you have done here. Look here. Down left, you can do undo, redo, or reset. Okay? So if you have made a mistake, they will undo the last movement that you have done. Everybody follow me? And imagine that you change many, many things, and at the end, you are not sure with the thing that you have done. You can go to reset, and reset gives you different options. You can reset everything, or you can reset only a few things. Okay? Imagine that you have done only mistakes with attachments. Okay? Disconnect the other options and only select the attachments. Okay? Or in the cuts. Okay? So you can decide the things where you want to move from the first clean check that you have received. Perfect. So now let's go to attachments. Look at the attachments that I have removed. In the centrals, I'm going to remove the attachments of the 11 because I don't need this attachment. So the way is go to attachments. You can press right button and remove attachment. Once again, right button, remove attachment. And other option is take the attachment and throw it to the garbage. Once again, right button, okay, remove attachment, or take the attachment with the left button and move it to the garbage. Everybody follow me? If you make a mistake, do undo. So try both options, please. Try the option with the right button, remove. Then undo the movement and take the attachment and move to the garbage with the left button. Fantastic. Another thing that we are going to do is to remove the power breeches. So also we select the attachment and cuts, go to the line, and right button, remove power breech, or you can take the power breech to the garbage. Everybody? And the same in the lower arch. We take the power reach to the garbage, or right button, remove. Fantastic. Now, I want you to copy these attachments in your thing. Why? Because they didn't put any attachments in the back, but I'm going to tell the technician that I want to expand the arch. Okay? So when you have to change the shape of the arch, I recommend you the first movement, explain that with the comments instead of doing by yourself, because to modify the shape of the arch to a parabolic shape is difficult with that. Okay? Okay, they don't allow you to modify the shape of the arch. They maintain the shape. So in the arch, if I expand, okay, I say upper and lower symmetric movement, full arch coordinate, and look at here. If I expand, they expand, okay, maintaining the shape. So it's much easier if we do the expansion, okay, telling them, okay, that you want to expand and change the shape, okay? So what we are going to do is go to attachments, and first let's work with the right view. Here you have the different attachment, vertical, and if you maintain the arrow over the attachment, you will see what is the attachment that you have. This one, for example, here is the vertical distal bevel attachment. The next one is vertical mesial bevel attachment. The next one is horizontal incisal or occlusal bevel. Rectangular gingival bevel attachment. Oval. You have different options. Okay, so we are going to put a 5 millimeter attachment, 5 millimeters in the 16. So go to attachments, take the attachments and move it to the 16. Okay? Now, with the 16, we are going to push the right button over the attachment, and we are going to select the 5 millimeters. Okay, we have moved the attachments over the tooth. Okay, I'm going to do it again. Okay, here, look at here. This is this one, horizontal gingival bevel attachment. Take the attachment and move it to the 6. And then push with the right button over the attachment and select the 5 millimeter. Fantastic. Now, I'm going to move a little bit to the center. So go over the attachment, push the left button, and move it to the center. And also, look at the screen, please. You can, with the circle, you can change the angulation. Okay? So what I want from a horizontal attachment is the thicker as possible, and the bevel has to be really increased. So I put this view, look at here, I put the arrow over the attachment, and with this line you can move the volume. Can you see? So I want the thicker attachment, okay? And also, with this line here, you can modify the angulation of the bevel. Okay? And I like to put this angulation of the bevel. Okay? Everybody can see that? So do it by yourself, please. Do the same now. I want you to do the same with the 26. Look at the screen. We want to put in the 26, put the same horizontal 5 millimeter attachment, gingival bevel, and in the 14 and 24, put the horizontal gingival bevel 4 millimeters. Okay, do it, please. Well, the bevel, look, I take the attachment to the tooth. Okay. Now I'm going to center a little bit. Perfect. Now I'm going to select the 5 millimeters. Okay. Perfect. And now put this view. Okay, with this view, go over the attachment. With this line, you can change the thickness. Okay, with this arrow. And with this one, with this arrow, okay, you go with the, you can change. Okay. So I want the thicker attachment, and also I want to increase the bevel. Okay? Yeah. And also, if you want, you can modify the angulation. So you can adapt the shape and the position to your own preference. Because, okay, depends on the movement that you are going to do. Okay, you can modify the position.
It is because it is just only one attachment. That's why you put on the molar and the molar.
No, it's because we are doing a practice, okay? But in this case, for example, that we are not going to expand a lot, just putting an attachment in the first premolar and the first molar is enough.
So, it needs to coordinate between molar and the molar angulation.
Sorry?
When you put two horizontal gingival attachment, we need to coordinate to have the same torque.
No. Okay, so everybody has put these attachments in the first molar and first premolar. And also now put a vertical attachment. Put a vertical attachment in the 23, because we are going to cut the aligner. Okay, we are going to cut the aligner to put a precision cut. Okay, in the lower arch, I want you to put horizontal occlusal bevel attachments in both lower molars, and we are going to move this attachment to mesial as much as possible. Okay, so because we are going to do a cut to bond a button, I'm going to put the horizontal occlusal bevel. Okay, okay, if you start working, look at the screen, please. Imagine that you start moving with the rotation and you lose a little bit the control. Okay, and you don't want, you cannot put in the, okay, in the initial picture to work. So if you make a mistake and you are losing the control of the rotation, go here, and then you press the left view. Okay, you turn to the zero. Okay, imagine. Okay, I don't know how to go back. Okay, so go here. Okay, and the horizontal attachment that we are going to use, we can modify the position. Also, look at here. You can modify. So we are going to move as much as possible to mesial. Okay, if I put here, I can cut better the attachment to both a button. Okay, or you can put it in the middle, occlusal also, but I prefer to put it here. Okay, in the four, we are going to put an horizontal occlusal bevel in the fore, and also less increase the bevel. Because we are going to use the first premolar for anchorage to intrude the lower incisors. So for intrusion of the lower incisors, we need anchorage in first premolar, occlusal bevel attachment. So we go there, right button, 4 millimeters. Okay, once again, right button, 4 millimeters. And then go to the bevel, increase the bevel. You can reduce if you want. Okay. Adapt, you can adapt the. Okay. And do the same in the other side. Okay. With that view, we can modify the thickness and also the angulation of the bevel. Everybody can do it.
Just a little bit for them to practice.
Over there.
Okay.
Yes, I'm going to put, let's put the other one in the first molar. Okay. And now, before going to the next stage, go to reset. Everybody, go to reset and reset everything.
Everything.
Okay? You're from zero again?
Yeah.
So, from zero. By yourself, again, remove all the IPR and put these attachments in your cases. Okay? Do it again, please. Okay? Start from zero, remove all the IPR. Okay? So go here to reset. No, here, disconnect this part. This one you don't need that. Reset. No. Select everything. Everything is select. And then go to reset.
This three rectangle is the same. Just this three. The occlusal, gingival, and horizontal.
This horizontal is without bevel?
Yeah, this is without bevel. I mean, this is with bevel.
With bevel.
So it's the upper size.
No, it's the same. You put the arrow over the attachment. Put the arrow over the attachment.
This one is.
Gingival. Yes, sir. Gingival. And. Okay, do it. It's clear? You know how to do it? Please, everybody, look at the screen, please. Look at a moment to the screen.
Okay.
I can see that you have this. Look at the screen, please. Go to tools. Go to tools. And tooth movement table that most of you have on the screen, disconnect that, please. Go here. Okay? Cancel. Or in tools. Okay, and two movement table, disconnect two movement table. We don't need that now to modify the clean check. Okay, now I only want in the screen the model of the 3D. Okay, it's clear for everybody?
Yes.
So you can disconnect that in two movement table, go to tools and disconnect, or also here you can cancel here. Okay, so everybody, okay, practice please. Removing the IPR, putting the attachments.
Sorry, I want to ask a question. What's the difference between these three horizontal rectangular attachments?
Put the arrow over that, it's telling you.
I know, because if I put a horizontal rectangular attachment on my cube, I still can change the bevel.
Yeah, you can change in all of them.
Yeah.
But even if you put the horizontal, you can put the level. But by default, if you go to the gingival, it's giving you the gingival level. By default. And also you can increase a little bit, but you have that from the beginning.
So if I only use the horizontal rectangular, even I change the variable, the aligner still won't put force on it.
Yes.
Okay, I know.
Yeah. Well, when they want, well, yes, it's for the talk. No, the rotation is the same. Okay? Sorry? The gingival, yes. Yeah, but any of these horizontal works exactly more than it's my own preference, but any of them are good for that. Okay? You need this one? Yes, also. Okay? Here? But now push the. Okay. To everybody know how to change the size? The size is the right to go over the attachment, right button. Okay, over the attachment, right button. 5 minutes. Oh yes, it's the max. When you cannot do that, and go over here. Right. You go put the arrow over the attachment. Right. Good. And then you can do 4 millimeters, or you can remove the touch. Is this your level? It's telling you, okay? Is this a level or gingival level? For extrude, normally the gingival level, but both of them work. So you don't okay, everybody know how the size? Okay, if you put over the attachment, you cannot change the size because the button is not working. Move the arrow outside the attachment and move back again. Okay. Disconnect this, please. You don't need that. Disconnect this. What are you telling me? Okay, let's move. Let's continue. Now, we are going to look at the screen. I remove the power reaches. I remove the power reaches. Okay, now what I want to do is to reduce the torque of the upper incisors. But to reduce the torque of the upper incisors, I have to reduce the torque of the lower incisors. Okay? So let's go to the occlusal view of the lower arch. Lower arch, occlusal view. Okay, go here, lower arch, occlusal view, and then here select tooth. Okay, you can decide the movement of crown and root. Okay, tooth, and now we are going to retrocline the lower incisors. Okay, but to retrocline the crown, I have to compensate the first the root. So go here, root torque, and we are going. If you use this arrow, in each point you modify 1 degree. Okay, if you want to modify using this, look at here, with this point, I'm giving 1 degree of buccal root torque each time. Everybody see that? With this line, I'm giving 1 degree of buccal root torque. If I go to the other one, I'm giving 1 degree of lingual root torque. Okay? Or you can go over the arrow, okay? You can go over the green line and modify like this. Okay? So I'm going to, before giving crown, lingual crown torque, I'm going to compensate a little bit the buccal root torque in the 4 incisors. I'm going to give some buccal root torque. Okay? And now go here and give lingual crown torque. Perfect. Now I see that the speed curve is increased. So what I'm going to do, I want to intrude more from 3 to 3. So go here to the intrusion tool, intrusion tool, select, and then select the 33, push control, and select the other 6 together, and then do the intrusion. I move back again. I move back again. So go here, the intrusion tool, select the 33. Now push control. And 32, 31, 32, 41, 31, 32. I'm pushing control, 33, and together I can do symmetric intrusion. Okay? Perfect. doing that, I'm taking, look at here, look at the overjet that I have now. This is what I need at the beginning. Okay? I need this overjet to solve the class 2. Okay? And let's go to the upper arch. And now we will practice, okay? With the upper arch, we are going to do the same. First, we are going to compensate the root torque. Go to the 11, sorry, the 12, and give back al root torque. The 11, the same. Okay? But now what we have to do is lingual root torque. Okay? So, because we are going to read the crown torque. So, lingual root torque. Now, some lingual root torque to the 12. Some lingual root torque to the 21. Some lingual root torque to the 22. Okay? And now go to the crown and we are going to reduce a little bit. We are going to reduce a little bit. You can do it like this, or you can go to the arrow and do like this. And now we are going to intrude also. We're going to intrude from lateral to lateral. Now we have less overjet. We're going to intrude first the 4. So I select the 12. I push control. Sorry. Go to the intrusion tool. I push control. And I do it with the 4 incisors. And I do intrusion of the 4. Okay? And now, because I want to reduce the gap between the lateral incisors and the centrals, okay? Because I want to reduce the gap between the lateral and the center, I have intruded first the 4, and now I'm going to intrude a little bit more the both central incisors. I select the 11, I push control, the 21, and I intrude a little more. Okay? So, we have less overjet, but we have enough overjet to let the elastic work. Okay? Everybody? So once again, now reset all your movement. Don't think now, forget about. So reset all the movement, everybody. Reset all the movement. Go to the. Go here to attachment. Everybody, reset. Okay, go here to attachments. Disconnect the attachments. Go here to IPR and hide controls of IPR. Okay? And only let's work with the torques of the upper incisor and the intrusion. Do it, please. Start with the lower incisors. The lower incisor first. Buccal root torque. Okay? So go here, disconnect the attachments and the IPR. This is here. Sorry. Is there? Is there two? So let's start with the lower arch first. In the 4 lower incisors, increase the Packard root torque. Do it symmetric, okay? The fork has to look the same. Then give lingual crown torque. And then intrude from 3 to 3. Yes. Disconnect this, please. Well, for the torque, don't do a simultaneous movement. For the torque, do it 2 by 2. For the intrusion, you can do it together.
If
I didn't lock the other two positions, the other two will have some difference. Yes, but then that's why it's better not to do that. Don't take this one. Okay, do you know how to do it? Okay? Bacal root torque first, then lingual crown torque. They have to look symmetric. Then go from 3 to 3 and do a mass intrusion. Okay? And then do the same with the upper arch. If you want to know the amount of intrusion that you are doing, you can select the grid. Look at the screen. If you want to know the amount of intrusion that you are doing, select the width. So you go, okay, we select the width, we go to the control, and we can measure the amount of intrusion that we are doing. Okay? Everybody? So, and if you want to intrude, look at here. Look at the screen, please. You want to apply the G5 protocol. We want to do the action reaction. So we select the incisors and the canine, and we are going to intrude 1 millimeter more. And also, I want to extrude premolars. I select the 45, 44, okay, press control, 35, 34, and extrude, okay, so, and then I will explain in my instructions that I want to apply the protocol of anterior intrusion and posterior extrusion at the same time. Okay? You have to repeat. So together you can do the anterior intrusion and posterior extrusion together. Okay, remember that then in my comments, you have to activate your comments and write, look at here, click to the screen. In my comments, you have to activate and then please, while you do the intrude, you can write here whatever you want. Okay? Perfect. So let's check the occlusal view. And now look at the rotation of this premolar. The 45, as you can see, is mesial inrotated. We go to the 45 and we select the rotation tool. Okay? So you can improve the rotation. In the upper, for example, you want to improve the rotation of this lateral a little bit if you want. This premolar, look at this one. So now, don't you think this is amazing?
Mm-hmm.
There is no excuses right now to get the perfection of your case. There's no excuse. We know how they have to look, okay? We know what are the rotation, we know the contact points that we need. And if the technician is a little bit short, don't worry, okay? Do your work and then explain the way you want to work that, like that, okay? Of course, it needs time. But the good things needs time, okay? Good things needs time. There is no shortcuts for nothing, okay? For many people, the rotation of these premolars are fine. For me, not. Okay? And also, let's look to the tip of these incisors. We have this black triangle here. Why we have this black triangle here? Because this root is distal inclined, and also this one, and the contact point is to occlusal. Okay? So let's go to the tool to modify the tip, and then let's do some IPR. Okay. And then we don't have the black triangle, okay? I have modified the tip of the incisors, and I moved the contact point more gingival, and then I have done some IPR. But it's necessary to do the modification of the tip, because look at here, if I okay, if you don't modify the tip here and you do IPR, you are going to do IPR, but the contact point is going to stay exactly the same here in fissile. So before doing the IPR, we have to modify the tip. Okay, if you want to be really precise, okay, go here to the arrow and modify 2 degrees. The 21. Modify 2 degrees. Look how the contact point is moving more gingival. And now add the IPR. .5 millimeters. Okay? Look how the roots looks parallel. And if you want more intrusion, control and intrude a little bit. Okay, if you like the, for example, if you like the incisors in the same, look at here. And then, if you like the lateral incisor 1 millimeter shorter than the centrals, you can put the, look at the screen, please.
Yeah.
You can put the incisal edge of the central over a line, and then take the lateral and move 1 millimeter shorter. Okay, here is exactly 1 millimeter shorter, or maybe you prefer only 0.5 millimeter. Okay, 1 millimeter shorter, or maybe you like 0.5 millimeter. Okay. So go to the occlusal view, disconnect the grid, and please give me mesial out rotation of the 4 upper molars. Give me mesial out rotation of the 4 upper molars, please. Because we are going to expand the arch, so while we expand, we have to derotate. So give me some mesial out rotation. The rotation is here. Where is it put? Yes. And now rotate. Put over the line and rotate. This distal in, mesial. Like this. Okay? Look, a way to yeah, look, if we want to, in this case, for example, in this case that we have some class 2, look at here, look at the screen, please. Okay, we have some class 2. We are going to expand the arch.
Arch.
A little bit. Okay? And then go to the that view, select the rotation, and move the mess, the cusp to a class 1. So you can see the amount of rotation that you need to go to class 1. Okay? So to derotate, put this view, and look how I'm derotating and I'm moving the mesial cusp to the center of the lower, to a class 1. Okay? Everybody can see? So we want to achieve the class 1. So we derotate, moving the mesial cusp to the middle. Okay? And now I'm going to coordinate the second molar. Okay? In the other view, exactly the same. I take the first molar, mesial out rotation to class 1. Then I go to the second molar and I compensate. And I can do the same with the first premolar, with the second premolar. And then, if you go here, you can compare with the original. So you can see the difference between the initial situation and the amount of movement. Yes? Let's move to the other case. We have break time now?
Yeah.
At lunchtime?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so let's, what we are going to do is eat, but eat fast.
Yeah.
Can everybody, I want to see your computer screen like this one. Select the teeth, tooth, and select this tool. Everybody, in your computer screen. Everybody. And after you're done, then we need to turn your computer this way because we want to make a good photo. And every computer look like this. Looks good. Okay? Yeah, that's right. Good. She is fast. Okay. Any question?
Yes.
Make it bigger.
And make it bigger. So you can look. You can the way to do it bigger. Go to this arrow here. Look, upper right. And look, upper right. And eliminate the text.
Or put an attachment. You need an attachment. Select the attachment.
If you finish, please turn your screen, turn your computer to our camera. So we're going to take a good picture of this.
Everyone.